Good evening, ma'am.
Evening, very very good evening, very good evening. Welcome to this evening session. And
good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, and we get on with, I think, the page that we are on is yes, help me. I think we were on page 107. We did not finish, I think, page 107. Hello, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So he is telling us, Prospero here is telling us why he needs heavenly music. And already solemn music has been produced. All the spirits obey him, you know, instinctively, immediately. They don't delay when an order comes from Prospero, right? So already solemn music, we are told, is on. It's already being played by the spirits of the air. And yesterday I shared, they have all entered a circle. So that's all you already know. And now he is sharing some more thoughts. A solemn air is the best comforter. He's telling us why he needed that solemn air. Why did he need that heavenly music? Because it comforts an unsettled fancy. Because it is able to comfort, it is able to cure. The solemn music is able to cure unsettled mind. When the mind is distracted, this is where I think the session ended. I remember when I was, I think, trying to ask you that, do you think music can contribute in increasing your attention? What do you say? Unmute and talk. Do you think the music helps in studies? If there is a background music, or if you've plugged in some music in your ears and studying, do you think it helps you? Unmute and share your thoughts, please.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, it helps.
It does, Abhay. And have you ever been scolded for doing this?
No, ma'am.
Oh, great. So that's very well. That's good, because that means your parents are very understanding about this part. Anyone else who has any other opinion to share about music and studies, the combination, the marriage between music and studies?
Ma'am, while solving maths exercise, I love to listen to music.
Oh, really? What kind of music, sweetie? Like, just to understand, your generation, you know, what kind of music would you play at that time?
I'm chirping, bird Ma'am? Chirping.
Achha, all right. And sweetie, you?
Punjabi songs.
Achha. You mean to say even a rap and a fast beat music?
No, ma'am.
Then?
Ma'am, not fast. Sometimes popping. What should I say? Rocking song sometimes, or sometimes.
Achha. Maybe that helps you. What happens is to your mind stays more alive and more alert.
Ma'am, please repeat.
I said, what is the contribution of music at that time? Does it keep your mind more alert and energized?
Yes, ma'am, but because it makes me feel too boring time when I solve maths without hearing music.
Wow, that's lovely. Wonderful to hear this. Anyone else who would love to share this part? This is so lovely. I'm enjoying this part. When you are tired. Yes, Abhay.
And it just makes my mind very much concentrating on my studies, as it is very much I'm revolving around the world. So it makes it only a center.
Wow, that's lovely. So that means here you're talking about music having a quality that it can fix your attention. It can help you focus. Anyone else, if you would like to share at this time, the we kind of are agreeing with Prospero. So therefore, I'm asking you live, you know, that as I said, see, English is not about on pages. English has to be in our life. You know, it is something that are we relating to whatever is happening on those pages? That is when English becomes more alive and more happening. Yes, Abhay and Sweetie, thank you so much for sharing those, because I remember when I was your age, I would do the same. Of course, we didn't have these facilities of earphones and all that. And I used to have a small transistor. You probably would not have even seen it. And I would actually keep it. And at times, you know, my father had questions to ask that, are you sure you are studying or are you trying to fool yourself? So I said, Papa, please believe me, you know, that this is helping me. But the kind of songs I would listen to probably to focus my attention were little slow ones, you know, so that I didn't get up and start dancing. So I don't know how you stop yourself, Sweetie, if you're listening to a rock song. Because do you get that temptation to actually stand up and give a little jive session for a minute?
Yes, ma'am, sometimes.
And I think once you do it, then it's no harm also, you know, because then you can come back and study. All right. So I think that was lovely hearing from both of you, that you brought life into the whole English session by sharing your views. So that was wonderful. So therefore, I think when Prospero says that music, and especially he's talking of a particular kind of a music, heavenly music, is a comforter and it can settle down an unsettled, distracted mind. I think at least Abhay, Sweetie and I definitely agree, and we won't even argue on this. And I do not know about the others, though you've not shared your views. Probably you will agree to what Prospero is saying, or you may disagree. But Prospero says music has power. Music has power. It can cure thy brains. So much of science actually has also been done on this. That at times when people are very disturbed psychologically, or they're going through certain fits or, you know, depressions, then also doctors use music and all. So you can do your own research on this. However, it says that's the reason why he's playing this music. Now useless, boiled within thy skull. So he says at the moment, your brains, when he's talking about your, he means the three men of sin. He's addressing the three men of sin and saying that three men of sin, Alonso, Sebastian and Antonio, your brains are at the moment useless. They cannot compute. They cannot understand. They have no logic. They have no, absolutely, they are, it's like a phone without battery. Okay, can do nothing. Can do nothing. Right. So that's what is the situation of their brains. And I remind you, this is the power of Prospero's magic, that brains are there, but they have been, it's like muted or disabled. It's something like some function which has been disabled. It's like that magic, that he has disabled their brains by his magic. So they are boiling within your skull. At the moment, he says your brains are boiling within your skull. They are only being consumed. They're only consuming the battery, but they're not switching on. I think I could use this kind of a parallel, that the battery is being consumed. Oh yes, you know, it's like those apps open at the background, it says, and the power is being consumed, or the data is being consumed, or the battery is being consumed, but they are not enabled and they cannot help. So the condition, this is for short question, those of you are taking it today, the condition of the brains of the three men of sin are, the brains are useless and they are boiling within the skulls of their mind. There stand. So he says, now all of you stand there. You are standing in that circle and you are spell stopped. We go on to page 108. He says that your condition, he's kind of giving us a running commentary, because see, we are not there to see what is their condition, what is happening. This is like a cricket match or a football match happening and somebody telling us that, you know, okay, Jatin is taking the ball towards the, you know, center forward, and now he's passing it on to Dhruv, and now Dhruv is taking it forward. So somebody would give us a running commentary and let us know what's happening. So this is here, Prospero himself is letting us know exactly what is their condition and what is happening. So you all are spell stopped. You cannot do anything. You're absolutely immobilized. You're unable to move. They were earlier immobilized, if you remember, they were earlier imprisoned in the lime grove. From there, Ariel was given the power to bring from lime grove till this circle. And once now they have entered the circle, they again cannot move. They are again immobilized. They are again prisoners, you know, prisoners of magic. It's not that they are imprisoned by some, you know, rope or some chain. No, nothing like that. It's just that they are spell stopped. Stopped because of the magical spell, magical charm. Now we come to the how many parts have we done? 1, 2, 3, and this was the fourth part we just finished, all about their coming and standing in the circle. So this was kind of fourth part. Then the fourth part, I could say, began from re-enter area. Okay, just to revise for you, and in case you are revising later. So this fourth part of this real long speech is from re-enter area, and it finishes, say, till here, till spell stopped. Now we move on to the fifth part of this real long speech. And in each part, you see the mood of Prospero is changing. And I don't know if you'll agree with me. I want you to focus on this. I actually want to take your attention on this. And also keep noticing or keep writing down in your registers. Different qualities are being revealed in every part. You know, when we were in the first part, we understood some different qualities. He's humble, he's willing to thank. Second part, he was a little proud. Then third part, you know, we all got to know how what a strong minded person, determined person he is, that he can give up anything. You know, we may find it very difficult to give up things. I didn't take up this quality then, but maybe I can take it up now, that when he said, I'll abjure magic, you know, it's so difficult. Something you have given your life to somebody, you know, if you are told that, you know, you have done all this, say, maybe, you know, I can talk of maybe at your age, okay, a register you have made, notes you have made, and then if you are told to give it up, oh my God, I think most of us will be shaking and saying, no, don't, please, no, I can't this up, I cannot give this up, no, please don't take this register from me, how will I do things? So it's like, you know, your power, maybe your power is in the register, your power is in whatever, I'm just taking an example, but he could do it. He could. So the marvelous quality of being able to give up something to which you've given your whole life. He's given whole life to it, and he is willing to give it up. And nobody is asking him to do it. Best part is nobody actually asked him. It is somewhere from inside he feels that now that these people have become penitent, these people have are feeling apologetic. And I always keep repeating it. They haven't said a word of apology, but he says, since they are penitent, my soul drift does not extend further. He says, there's no need of magic now, and he's willing to give it up. Then we had the other part, and then where he's talking about music and all. So he gave us a good insight about music and his understanding of how music and madness are, you know, is a medicine. It can be a medicine for madness. So as we want to go to the fifth part here, again, keep noticing his qualities, and I'll be asking you after that. This time I won't tell you. I'll be asking you, what do you think of him here? The very first person that he starts addressing here, whom do you think he should address? Whom should he start talking to, the very first person? If you were in place of, and unmute and tell me, if you were there in Prospero's place, whom would you like to talk to, the very first person in that whole group of 5, 6?
Antonio.
Okay. Nave Bhardwaj says Antonio. Yes, Tanisha?
I'm Gonzalo.
Gonzalo. Okay, why Antonio? Let me ask Kabir first, then I'll ask Tanisha.
Because he was the main.
Okay, what is it that you would say to Antonio Abhay?
Ma'am, he'll remind him that what did you do with him?
Come on, let's have a good dialogue.
Dialogue to
make up one now. भाई ये क्या कह रहा तुमने राइट समथिंग लाइक
वैसे ही कुछ बोलेगा यस मैम
यू कैन डू इट टू इफ आई कैन डू इट टू हां सो हे ब्रो व्हाट
डिड यू डू विद मी
व्हाट डिड यू डू इट है ना सो समथिंग लाइक दैट ओके तनीशा शी चोज गोंजालो सो लेट्स हियर व्हाट व्हाई गोंजालो एंड व्हाट वुड यू से टू गोंजालो
मैम बिकॉज़ गोंजालो वाज अ वाइज मैन As he helped Prospero to escape from the Milan by giving him thanks.
Mm-hmm. So what would you say to him, like when you meet him after so many years? So like Abhay and I, you know, went talking in a different way. So what do you think you would say to Gonzalo? Anything that comes to your mind? Maybe we'll begin with a thank you. Yes, Priya, you want to say something?
Long time no see.
Oh, wow. All right. But then see, it's thankful. Hannah. So, long time no see, or maybe seeing you after a long time and it's a pleasure to see you after so many years and all that. Thank you. That's lovely. It's nice to have participation. You know, this is where I think of, you know, all these things as a project part. Isn't it? This is where I feel that all these small things that we keep doing in between, it make it more real, as I repeat myself, and also somewhere will help you in your projects and all, right? So let's hear what Prospero has to say. Holy Gonzalo, honorable man. Oh, he says, Gonzalo, you are a holy person. Oh my God, you know, look at that. Thanks, you know, coming out. He is brimming with thanks. He's overflowing with thanks. And he is calling him holy. Holy is the very first word. Now, holy is a word normally used for God. So I think, and we all, Tanisha just justified also to us that because he has given him all the help. And it was that help which helped him survive all that ordeal in that small bark and in that sea. So definitely he calls him holy. And then he goes on to give him another compliment. Honorable man, you are very honorable. You come somehow deserve all the honor that one can bestow on you. Mine eyes, even sociable to the show of thine, fall fellowly drops. He says, he doesn't call him only Gonzalo. It's like, when we are addressing somebody we love, somebody we honor, you know, we would not actually just take up the name. We actually may have some epithet. We may use some sobriquet. We may use some kind of, you know, adjective or some word to increase the or to show the respect to that person. So therefore, that's all these things are really important. And Prospero, how much ever, you know, he may be great in many things, but when it comes to being, when it comes to honor others, he has got his ABC right. You know, he sure knows. He is humble enough to honor others in the right way. He may be a king, he may be a duke, he may be whatever and whatever not, but he has not forgotten his courtesies. Holy Gonzalo, I repeat, and then he goes on to compliment him and giving him calling him an honorable man. And then he says, you know, Gonzalo, even my eyes are crying. Which means Prospero has started crying at this time. He has tears in his eyes. He says, even my eyes, sociable to the show of thine, joining, they are being sociable. They are responding to your eyes crying. When I see your eyes crying, who told us that Gonzalo was crying? Give me the line.
Ariel.
Ariel, give me the line. Give me the line. Good. Give me the line. Quick, page 106, find the line.
From line 17.
Yes. Read out, sweetie.
The good old Lord Gonzalo, his tears run down his beard.
Wonderful, wonderful. Like very winter. Good. Yes. And then he has the imagery to tell us, you know, what those teardrops are looking like. Wonderful. His tears run down his beard. He has been crying, Ariel told him. And now, when he sees Gonzalo, maybe Gonzalo is still crying because he is very upset. Now, see, this is again speaks volumes about Gonzalo's character also, isn't it? So keep noting, keep putting down, you know, in your book or in your register that if you are not able to find the quality of Gonzalo or Prospero here, you can at least write down, you know, Gonzalo and Prospero and leave it as a question mark. That you have to think about the quality, because this is a homework I'm giving you right now. Or if you're not able to hit upon the quality, then at least you will revert and ask me or ask your friends that what do you think are the qualities that can be put here. So he says, even my eyes are falling, even my eyes are dropping. Fall here means they are dropping fellowly drops, the drops of tears to join yours, you know. So that's how, this is what the very first thing Prospero has to say. Then the charm dissolves apace. Next thing, first thing he does was to actually, now I must point out here, just a second children, this battery is showing it's running low. Just give me a second. Came back to life. I think I missed out on plugging it today. So this was the very first thing. He couldn't have stopped himself. He didn't want to do anything else. Now that Gonzalo is in front of him, it's like Bharat Milan, isn't it? Something like that. It's like meeting after years, and he probably had been thinking in his mind, will I ever meet Gonzalo to thank him, to touch his feet, to hug him, whatever he would like to do. So he couldn't stop crying. Why do you think? We know why Gonzalo is crying. He's crying at the sorry state of, at the distracted state of Alonso. You agree? This is the reason you think Gonzalo is crying? I'll need your response. Unmute and keep talking. Why do you think is Gonzalo crying? I'm trying to understand this. What has made him cry? What has made Gonzalo cry? Okay, I think we are being told this. Yes, do speak up, Rudrika, yes. Why is Gonzalo crying? Come on, you all know.
Maybe he's crying because his king is sad and have gone mad. No, he's not mad at this time. So he's crying because he cannot do anything.
Exactly. And he cannot do anything. For whom?
For his king and Sebastian and Antonio, he cannot do anything, cannot help him.
Very good. Exactly. You can understand such a loyal person who he is, and he finds himself helpless, and he feels that, how do I help my king, topmost authority? Then how do I help the Duke of Milan, Antonio? And then how do I help Sebastian? And he can do nothing, and you understand, he is such a loyal person, with now loyal banda hai. That he did so much for Prospero, he, you know, packed him with all the best of the things that could have, you know, what it require. So therefore, you can understand how sorry he is feeling, how helpless he is feeling. And therefore, when we feel helpless at times, we start crying. Very good answer. Very well worded and very good answer. That was Priya. And why do you think is, now my next question, short question would be, why do you think is Prospero beginning to cry? Yeah, unmute and talk. Why do you think is Prospero beginning to cry at this time?
मैम आपको वॉइस क्लियर नहीं आ रही
मैम पीछे वाइब्रेशन क्यों हो रही है बार बार
बहुत ज्यादा वाइब्रेशन हो रही है
मैम आपकी वॉइस बहुत लो आ रही है बहुत
नाउ बेटर
वाइब्रेशन मैम वाइब्रेशन से आ रही है
Even I can hear the vibration, but what is causing it? Is it better now?
Yes, ma'am.
No,
baby.
I think still are a vibration. Even I can hear it.
Yes, ma'am. ईयरफोन का शायद कोई इशू नहीं
लिटिल सेटल्ड और स्टिल बैड एज हाउ इज इट नाउ
मैं स्टिल वैसा ही है
व्हाई विश यू थोड़ा बहुत बेटर हुआ आई विश आई वाज अ टेक्नीशियन यू नो Something about this part. Hello, 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 hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Better?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. आ तो रही है मैम पर बहुत लो आ रही है सुनाई तो दे रहा है.
Hello. Hello.
Yes.
I'm still
mm-hmm.
very low.
No, ma'am. Hello, is this better?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thoda sa clear.
Is it better? I have actually unplugged and now speaking directly. So I'm asking you.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am. It's better now.
Is it better?
Yes. Ma'am, earphone ka issue hoga shayad.
Ha, I think so. My earplugs could be dying. They don't yes, survive, ma'am. You know, more than what, 2 months, I think so.
Yes, ma'am.
I think I'll do one thing. In any case, it tells me, I don't know how much time are we left with. Will we be able to finish it? Take up a little more? If my voice is better, then I'll go ahead. Otherwise, I would like to stop here. You tell me.
Yes, no, ma'am. Now it's clear.
It's clear? All right. Then this is better yes, than ma'am. I can even do it without the earphones. If my voice is loud and clear right now. Good, then this is still better. Probably we'll have to buy another set of ye chala gaya mujhe lag raha hai. All right. So yes, I was asking that why is Prospero crying? We understood why Gonzalo is crying. Now let's try and understand why do you think Prospero has started crying at this time?
Man, because Prospero is the one who made the female of sin like this. They go all weird and made Gonzalo feel helpless. So Gonzalo is crying because he's helpless.
And you mean to say he is
because?
Mm-hmm, yes, yes. Go on.
He is the one who caused Gonzalo to cry.
Oh wow!
Indirectly.
I love that. I love that. That is a wonderful connection. You know, even I never thought of it like that. That he is crying because he Gonzalo cry. That's wonderful.
I think you note it down, children, because this is, like I said, you know, when I'm with young children, I get lovely perspectives, very different ones. Batch, you know, there'll be something new coming up. Every batch, you know, I always have something or the other new coming up. And this is like wonderful that he feels sorry to have made his wonderful helper, Gonzalo, cry. So this could be one of the reasons, as Priya is trying to tell us. And I think that's very original, very original. And any other reason that anyone add up here? So one thing is certain, I think one thing we can all decide is that he's crying not for Alonso, Sebastian and Antonio, but he is crying for Gonzalo. Can we all agree on this? See, I you know, I really want you to be unmuting yourself and talking. We have chatted enough, and chat also all right. But then I would really love that, because at the same time, you know, you get time to talk and be on the mic, and I get to hear your lovely voices. You know, I really miss your voices and I really miss your faces. But face, I am not switching on the video because I just thought it takes on a lot of data. But I get tempted to ask you to switch on and myself. But then I think, oh my God, you know, there's such a lot of data that gets consumed. So at least, please, 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 let me hear your voices at least. You know, it makes me feel good. I really miss those voices when we were back in school, classroom, actual classroom, real classroom. I used to enjoy hearing your voices. So that is the reason why I say that. So now he says that the charm is dissolving. So this is running commentary going on. He tells, he's told us he's crying. He's crying along with Gonzalo. कभी कभी ऐसा भी होता है ना कि हमारा दोस्त रो रहा होता है, हम भी रोने लगते हैं. कभी हुआ आपके साथ ऐसा?
Yes, ma'am.
कई बार होता है ना?
और कुछ शायद ये connection.
क्यों रो रहे हो? Yes, ma'am. मालूम नहीं, ये रो रहा है, हम भी रोने लगे, पता नहीं क्या हो गया. Has it ever happened?
Yes, ma'am.
You know that friends' sadness or friends crying sometimes can melt our hearts, and you know we start crying. So I think this could be also one of the other reasons you can add in case a short question is asked on that. Now he's telling us the next point in this fifth part. The charm, the magical spell, is dissolving. He says now it is beginning to dissolve. It is beginning to go away. It is losing its intensity. It is becoming battery kam ho rahi hai, you know, it's like iska intensity is getting lesser and lesser and lesser, because already excuse me already solemn music is playing, and ever since solemn music has started playing, the charm has started dissolving apace, slowly and slowly. And as the morning steals upon the night, melting the darkness, so their rising senses begin to chase the ignorant fumes that mantle their clearer reason. I think this is a little bigger imagery used here. I think
your parents ka phone.
Much time left to take it up today. It'll get halfway done. So I'll leave it for tomorrow. I think when we meet for tomorrow's session, then I'll take up this
complete imagery
and explain to you. He is still telling us in this imagery how and in which manner the spell is becoming less and less intense. How is it dissolving? He is going to give a beautiful description about it. And that is what I leave it in pending, and we'll do it tomorrow. Instead, I'll move on to the next line as of now, and we'll take up that later. Oh, good Gonzalo, my true preserver. He gives him another compliment. Good. Then he calls him, so look at the sobriquet, true preserver. He says, if I'm alive today, it's all because of you. I owe my life to you. O-W-E. Main agar aaj zinda hoon, to uski wajah aap hain. So he says that I owe my life to you. You are my true preserver. Had you not been there, had you not given those all those important things needed, I probably would have died, and so would have my daughter. And next, he has a plethora of compliments to give. Kabhi kabhi dil itna compliments se bhara hota hai kisi kisi ke liye ki ek compliment pe rukne ka man nahi karta. Man karte aur acha. Nahi, aap aise bhi hain, aap ye bhi hain, are aap mein ye bhi hai, aap ye bhi hain. Man nahi mangta. Jab tak ki hum log sara ka sara, you know, we don't pour out the entire rain of compliments. So he is raining compliments on him because he feels he deserves a rain of compliments, and one word would not suffice, one word would not be enough. So he says, you are loyal, sir, to him you followest. And this is what right from the beginning I've been talking about, and you can underline this, that whomever you follow, you are loyal to that person. He says, आपकी लॉयल्टी को आज मैं सल्यूट करता हूँ. When you were working with me, when I was your duke, you were so loyal to me that even when I was usurped, you were loyal, you gave me things. Period. Finished. Curtain down. Now, you have a new duke, Antonio, and you were so loyal to the new duke. Never mind if the duke is good or bad. You're so loyal to your king. You're so loyal to King Alonso. So this is a wonderful quality, and this is what can be asked as a full question, you know, on long question on Gonzalo, that do you agree that he is really a person very loyal to whomever he decides to follow? I think I'll bring an end to this session because I have another class, and I already see my kids of the other class, you know, 11th, waiting outside. So I think, and they're very impatient because they're so new to the whole thing, and you know, they feel they shouldn't miss out anything. So I think that I'll stop there for this session, and thank you so much for being there. And I really enjoyed hearing all about the music and all those different comments that you gave, and thank you so much for being so interactive. Yes. And so live and keeping me happy. Hope I could make you happy too.
Yes.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye, ma'am.
See you tomorrow. See you tomorrow. Ma'am says goodbye. Bye-bye.
Good evening.
Very good evening. Very good evening.